Hello, I am Dr. Prashant Kumar. Today we are going to talk on analgesic medications in acute renal failure. On a standard nephrology review, we found that they had advice of no NSAID therapy for acute renal failure. So it's a very limiting situation for a patient who has acute renal failure and has severe pain also. Let us talk on this topic so that we can clarify on what are the medication options for acute renal failure and pain, and what options can be worked out on this situation. First of all, let us consider the types of pain. Pain can be broadly of two types: nociceptive pain and neuropathic pain. And there is another category which is a mixture of the two, that is nociceptive and neuropathic pain, that is called a mixed pain pattern. So most of the pain we encounter in acute renal failure or in ICUs in general are of mixed origin. Otherwise, if we consider it, neuropathic pain examples are such as trigeminal neuralgia, and nociceptive pain types can be because of the wound infection, inflammation, or classical example can be rheumatoid arthritis. So whenever we are considering pain situation, generally we should presume it to be of mixed origin unless otherwise it is a specified situation. The other classification of a pain situation is on the basis of chronology. It can be acute or chronic. If the pain persists for more than 3 months, this is categorized into chronic variety. Chronic pains are generally due to neuropathic situation. So we have different co-analgesics available to deal with the chronic pain types, and that is a separate discussion altogether. Now we focus on acute renal failure with acute pain. Whenever a nephrologist advises that non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs are contraindicated, I presume this advice is not appropriate. The reason is that non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs are contraindicated in general and in a long-term basis, but not in acute situation. And there are some non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs which are completely safe in acute renal failure. The classical example of non-steroidal drugs which are completely safe in acute renal failure is ibuprofen, naproxen, low-dose aspirin. Aspirin in doses up to 300 mg per day is completely safe in acute renal failure. There is one another aniline derivative. This is known as acetaminophen or paracetamol, which is completely safe in acute renal failure. Therefore, we have four drugs in total which are completely safe in acute renal failure. That is, one is paracetamol, other is ibuprofen, third is naproxen, and the fourth one is nefopam. Nefopam is a non-NSAID, non-opioid, centrally acting analgesic. The mechanism of action is probably related to inhibition of reuptake in the brain. Nefopam is completely renally safe. It can be given in doses of 20 mg 2 or 3 times a day. It is available in both tablet and injection form, and it can be used in renal failure patients. There is no inhibition of the GFR and it is completely renally safe. The other analgesic category which can be utilized in acute renal failure of moderate to severe pain is opioids. Opioids are generally contraindicated in renal failure, but there are some drugs which can be used in acute renal failure. The number one is tramadol. Tramadol is completely renally safe in patients up to a doses of 200 to 300 milligram per day, and this can be used in acute renal failure. There is no accumulation of the drug in the acute renal failure. The other drug which can be used in acute renal failure is fentanyl. Fentanyl is also very safe in renal failure. It does not damage the kidneys, and it is not accumulated in normal therapeutic doses, but on prolonged infusions it can get accumulated in both acute renal failure and otherwise in normal patients also. In general, opioids are not damaging to the kidneys. That means if we use opioids, the opioids do not harm the kidney, but yes, the metabolites can get accumulated. So Considering this point, we have two drugs which are completely renally safe. As I told, number one is tramadol, the other is fentanyl. The other drugs which can be used in small quantity in acute renal failure but should not be used for prolonged infusions or repeated doses is morphine. Morphine is a drug which produces morphine 6-glucuronide and morphine 3-glucuronide, which are the metabolites, and the metabolites are renally excreted. Therefore, in acute renal failure, these metabolites can get accumulated. Morphine 3-glucuronide is a stimulant and it can cause seizures in acute renal failure. Therefore, if you are using morphine, the dosage should be either adjusted or it should be used in one or two times only, not in repeated or infusions. Therefore, this way we can use opioids also in acute renal failure. And the last category of the drugs is actually a drug delivery system and biopatch. Biopatch is a drug delivery system in which the drugs are kept in a pouch and this is applied transdermally and the drug gets absorbed. Normally, biopatch should not be used in acute pain. The reason is that either we know the opioid doses and the quantity the patient is taking and the patient requires the drug for a prolonged period of time. But in acute renal failure, when we are stuck somewhere and we have limited analgesics available to use in acute renal failure, biopatch can be given a strong consideration for starting acute pain medicine in these patients. The only disadvantage is the cost, because if you are using this for 1 day or 2 day or 3 day, the other drug which is left in the pouch can be discarded and which will increase the cost. Therefore, this is a small discussion here enhances and highlights the importance of not avoiding non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug in acute renal failure. We can use non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug and opioids and biopatch all in acute renal failure, and we can achieve a good pain control in acute renal failure. Thanks for watching.